So, רבותיי, the parasha begins, אישה כי תזריע וילדה זכר. A woman conceive, she gives birth to a boy. It's written in a verse in Isaiah 58, verse 13. What does it say? אם תשיב משבת רגליך, עשות חפציך ביום קודשי, וקראת לשבת עונג, לקדוש אדוני מכובד, וכיבדתו מעשות דרכיך, ממצוא חפציך, ודבר דבר. What's all these words? All these words, what are they? וכיבדתו, שבת is male or female? The word שבת. What do you say, שבת יפה או שבת יפה? We had a beautiful Shabbat. You can say it in a female language or in a male language. In English, sometimes it's the same for male and female. You and you, it's for male and female. You don't know if he speaks to a man or a woman unless you're there. If you hear from behind the wall, you cannot come here. You don't know if he's yelling on a man or on a woman. You can be any one of them. But in Hebrew, it's different language. You, for men, is ata. For women, is at. So from hearing, you know if there is a male there or a female. You know who they're yelling at. It's very, very important. Shabbat. You say Shabbat is a female or it's a male? If it's a male, you say Shabbat yafeh. If it's a female, you say Shabbat yafa. But in the verse of the prophet Isaiah, in chapter 58, verse 13, he used Shabbat as a male language, not female. Very interesting. Or in the Torah, of God, it's written, Zachor et Yom HaShabbat Lekadsho. It should have been Lekadsha. Lekadsho, it's male. Lekadsha, it's female. But in a different place in the Torah, in Parashat Ki Tisa, it's written, Beni uven bnei Yisrael, Ot hi leolam. Shabbat is now called in a female language. He, not who. Or we say, Shabbat HaMelech or Shabbat HaMalkah. Shabbat is a king or Shabbat is a queen. Queen. Shabbat HaMalkah. So what is Shabbat, male or female? You hear the questions or no? We have a rule in the Torah, in the creation, not just in the Torah, that you have male and female in every system, in every species, in every place in nature, you have a giver and you have a receiver. A giver and a receiver. It's called mashpia u'mushpa. So one that influence and one that receive the influence. Is influenced with ED. Influenced. The mashpia, the one that influence is the male. The one that received the influence is a woman, just like in intimacy. The man is the giver and the woman is the receiver. In all 2 million species in nature, it works the same way. You don't have any species that the woman, the female, gives something to the male in order for the male to receive something from the female. It's always the male that gives something to the female. Also in a wedding, the husband is putting the ring on the finger of the woman. The woman does not give a ring to the man like the goyim made it up, or the chilonim. We don't do it. There's no such thing, wedding ring for men. You never find a charedi with a wedding ring, unless if he's a modern faker. Or not faker, just modern. Not everyone is a faker, obviously, just doesn't know any better. The woman doesn't give ktuva to the man. Even if the woman is a billionaire and the man is a bachur yeshiva, doesn't have a dollar to his name. He has to give a bill of rights to the woman. It's his responsibility to sponsor her. If he takes her out to eat, he has to pay. It's not like the feminist world that you go to a secular court and they make the woman pay alimony and child support to the husband that she just divorced. This is a corrupted world of wicked people that they want women to take over the world. They want women to become men. They want men to become a woman. They messed up the plan of God. They messed up the plan. So Shabbat, it's a female. It's a receiver. Where does Shabbat receive from? From the 6 days of the week. The 6 days of the week, feed Shabbat. You prepare, you cook. Everything you prepare in the 6 days for Shabbat. As it's written in the Gemara, מי שטרח בערב שבת, יאכל בשבת. Someone who worked hard before Shabbat to prepare Shabbat will have what to eat on Shabbat. He's ready. Also, we don't work on Shabbat. How do we have food to buy everything we need for Shabbat? From the work in the 6 days. Meaning Shabbat is receiving her wealth from the 6 days of work. But that's an optical mistake. That's what everyone will tell you, but that's a mistake. Why? Because it's written, לקראת שבת לכו ונלכה, כי היא מקור הברכה. Let's welcome Shabbat. Why? Shabbat is the source of all our blessing in life. Not only Shabbat is not just the receiver, Shabbat is the huge giver. All the blessings, plural, in our life, the source of it is from Shabbat. Someone who is a Jew that is not Shomer Shabbat has no blessing in anything in his life. Anything. Not with his marriage, not with raising his children, not in a partnership in a business, not in the money that he makes. He doesn't have blessing in it. He will never reach happiness. We call it grinding water. You can grind water all you want. You still have water after 50 years. You did not achieve anything besides wasting your effort for nothing. God say, the source of all blessing in life is Shabbat, when you do it right. So, it's written. It's written in a song we sing, in Lecha Dodi. Right? What do we sing? Likrat Shabbat lechu venelcha, ki hi mekor habracha. So Shabbat, that's why Shabbat sometimes is appeared in the Torah as a female, and sometimes is appeared as a male. Because although Shabbat is the source of blessing and is giving us a lot, it's also receiving. Since Shabbat is a receiver and a giver, that's why sometimes it appears as male and sometimes as a female.